organizers. I welcome you all here in the session under Life Sciences. Today, our session chair is Dr. Hemangi Jambhekar. She is a managing director of Vasumitra Life Engineers Private Limited. She holds doctorate in earthworm farming. She is an eminent scientist in field of Sanjeevan agriculture, having developed unique solutions to various chemicals used in agriculture. She has developed a unique concept of farming based on Samved Sanjeevan system, which minimizes chemical inputs. Herbal products were developed by applying Patanjali Yoga Shastra concepts to crops, microorganisms, pests, insects and soil. The concept is successfully commercialized and has shown remarkable benefits to a number of farmers across India. With her permission, we are starting now today's session, and I request Dr. Anand Gaikwad to begin with his speech. All the speakers were given 8 minutes plus two for question answers.
Hey, sorry, I mean, let me clear it very well. This is a lead talk, and lead talk has been given 20 minutes, and the rest will be 10 minutes each. Is that correct? Huh? Oh yes, 90 minutes. All the whole session of 90 minutes. Well, that is the situation. I mean, that's what it was. This is what was decided. So I will have 20 minutes. Rest, about six of them are there. They will have 10 minutes each, and that is the total. Sorry for the confusion. I think, you know, these are some of the points which need to be taken care of by the organizers. Okay, when you talk about a lead talk, then the necessary time has to be given. I welcome you all to this. And I'm going to introduce a unique methodology of farming, which is called as Homa Organic Farming. Now, this gels very well with the present of the theme of this national conference, which is actually the confluence of the traditional and modern sciences. And during the talk, I will show you how the confluence takes place, and also the latest applications of this methodology. Now, to begin with, I mean, I will just for the benefit of all the people who may not be knowing organic farming is defined by the Department of Agriculture. Like, organic farming is a production system which avoids and largely excludes the usage of synthetically. Pardon? Am I audible? Sorry. Well, yes, I was referring to the department, the definition of organic farming by the Agricultural Department of USA. Now, there are three components in the definition. That is a farm production system which excludes the usage of synthetically compounded fertilizers, pesticides, and artificials, and relies upon crop rotation, animal manure, green manure, legumes, etc. And it establishes a biological control of pests and weeds. This is a very short definition. Actually, the definition should be an fully integrated system, which is self-contained and self-sustaining. That is, swayam poshit, swayam chalit. That is the organic system that one should have. These are the methods of organic farming. Is it okay? Is that okay?
Yeah.
We have seen this definition, the three components of definition, and these are the different methods of organic farming, natural farming, naturopa farming, naturopa farming by Professor S. A. Dabolkar, then zero budget spiritual farming of Subhaji Palekar, permaculture of Bill Mollison from Australia, biodynamic farming, which is a initiative, anthroposophic initiative of Rudolf Steiner, and Homa organic farming is the topic that we are going to talk about. Now this is just a picture of the Agnihotra Shala at my farm, which will give you that this is the arrangement which is made for Agnihotra, performance of Agnihotra at the time of sunrise and sunset. Now this forms a basic requirement as far as Homa farming is concerned. Now, my goodness. Anyhow, this is going to be, this is not compatible with the PDF files, were not copied, no? No, PDF file was not copied. What has happened is that the Sanskrit slokas will not come there. They will not be this thing, because that's all right. There should be font in that, so that may be the difficulty. We had actually transmitted the PDF files to the organizer. Okay, we will proceed with that. Now, the gospel truth about creating and keeping ecological balance through the yajna is given in Bhagavad Gita. Now, this is particularly the shloka 14 of chapter 3, which goes to the to say that due to yajna, it rains. Rains produce food, and all living beings survive on food. So this is how yajna is very important for the holistic approach for production of food. There is also one thing in Satpat Brahmana of Shukla Ajurveda, which says that yajna creates water vapors, that is aerosol nanoparticles. Water vapors, aerosol nanoparticles form the clouds, and clouds give the rains. This is how yajna is related to the environment, yajna is related to the yajna rains, as well as it is related to the production of food. Now, the basic philosophy of Agnihotra or Homa farming is heal the atmosphere, and the healed atmosphere will heal you. Agnihotra is the basic Homa for all Homa fire sciences or practices given in the Vedic text, Vedic sciences of bioenergy, psychotherapy, medicine, agriculture, biogenetics, climatic engineering, and interplanetary communications. Now, interplanetary communications needs to be emphasized. This is one of the very important aspects of the Homa farming. Now, this is just a relationship which is shown that yajna and how the atmosphere, biosphere, and agriculture are related. Basically, agriculture or this thing is a rhizosphere and biosphere. The in the atmosphere and biosphere, you have elements, different elements and environment, and also there is a space. There are sun, moon, planets, and the different constellations with which the agriculture as well as the environment is related. Now, this is one of the very important definitions which is in the Sanskrit text, and it is about the sunrise definition. The ancient traditional sunrise is described as follows. At sunrise, the many fires, electricities, ethers, and more subtle energies emanating from the sun extend all the way to the earth and produce a flood effect at those coordinates where the sun is said to rise. It is awesome. The flood envelops and purifies everything in its path, destroying what is impure in its wake. This torrent of light sustaining energies causes all life to rejoice. At sunrise, the music can be heard. The morning Agnihotra mantra is the essence of that music. It is the quintessential sound. At the sunset, flood recedes. Now, one might wonder that this particular description from the Vedic text, how it is related to the modern science and how it can be explained in modern things. Now, you will see here, so far there was no relationship, but in the astrophysics, this I have taken from the presentation of one Dr. Michael Claridge. Here, what it shows is that million ampere currents head towards the earth at sunrise and out along the sunset. It shows how the earth is entering the stream of solar winds at sunrise and turning out of these at sunset. Now this is what the modern astrophysics talks about, which is close to the definition which is given in the Vedic text of the sunrise. And that is why the Agnihotra is to be performed at the precise timing of sunrise and sunset. Well, Agnihotra is a little bit of Agnihotra. Agnihotra is a simplified Devayajna, and Devayajna refers to the entire responsibilities of ecological duties of man connected with personal, public and environmental health and hygiene. So we are not talking about just a person, but it is also related to the public as well as environmental health and hygiene. Homas or yajnas are to be seen as applied Vedic sciences for purification of atmosphere and dealing with pollution problems. They are also to be seen as science connected with aerosol science and climatic engineering. Yajnas are to be seen as scientific aids and techniques of solving environmental pollution problems, rejuvenating and enlivening soil and other natural sources of establishing connectivity with cosmos and natural forces and resources. They are not to be seen as mere religious rituals. It has taken thousands of years for humanity to give due recognition to yoga, but we do not have many years to recognize Yajna as a savior of humanity and environment, because planet Earth is fast deteriorating. Now, these are some research and development activities which have been carried out. They indicate that the Agnihotra or Yajna performances and also ashes therefrom purify the atmospheric elements like earth or soil, water and air, and thus will help in healing the atmosphere and bringing equilibrium in the natural elements and the seasons. This is just a pictorial photograph of this thing that you see. Here I had engaged a warli painter, basically dumb and deaf warli painter. I explained to him the concept of Agnihotra, and he had taken out a picture where the Agnihotra is performed. Sun rays from this thing, that the energy at the time of sunrise and sunset is captured, and it is broadcast. It is broadcast for the animal life, for the plant life, as well as for the water bodies. This is just the arrangement at the farm which is required to be there. There is Agnihotra hut, and on the four directions, there are four pillars on which Agnihotra pots are listed. This is called, in nutshell, a resonance plant. I will not go into the details of these particular arrangement, but what is important is that here these elements. Now you will see that in the agriculture there are basically two managements which one has to do: biosphere management and rhizosphere management. Now biosphere management, you will see that the whole intake of the plants that take care, almost more than 70% of the intake is from the atmosphere, and the balance is coming from the reserve. So if you want really to purify the atmosphere, Agnihotra or Yajnas are the remedies. That is why in Homa farming it is given as a predominance. Now in case of biosphere, whatever photosynthesis, flowering, fruiting and ripening, all these things take place in the atmosphere or in the biosphere. Whereas humus, capillary forces and nutrients, they act inputs. Now the energies which are captured from this thing, they are spread in the biosphere, and biosphere extends about 12 kilometers above the earth and 12 kilometers up to the depth of the oceans. So that is the biosphere in which you can have the effect. There are some things which have been done. Yes, Agnihotra, the Agnihotra Homas, Yajnas purify atmosphere and create protective shield of live bioenergy forces to work for the healthy plant life. And here in the application of biogas slurry, panchagavya, liquid organics and Agnihotra ash, they rejuvenate and enliven the soil. That is how the biosphere is managed, that is how the rhizosphere is managed. Yeah, now I will, in order to get the idea of Homa farming, what I have done is that I have compared this with the what can be called as the best organic method in the world. Now today, biodynamic farming is regarded and accepted worldwide as one of the best methods of organic farming. Now I have taken about 10 points for comparison in order to show how Homa organic farming is equally good and how many similarities are there between the two systems. So you will see that biodynamic farming, which has gained the ground world over, why Homa farming cannot get the ground. And in fact, when the two systems are similar, I actually call them as twin sisters of sustainable agriculture. Now, the first point of this thing is that the origin of biodynamic farming is in 1924, when Rudolf Steiner gave the 8 lectures, and those 8 lectures became the foundation of biodynamic farming. These 8 lectures were called as spiritual foundations for the renewal of agriculture. Now, in case of Homa therapy farming, although Homa therapy farming or Homa farming surfaced, came to the surface in 1986 after the publication of the book The Secrets of the Soil by Peter Tompkins and Christopher Berde, as well as Homa therapy or Last Chant by Sri Vasant Paranjpe, but its origin dates back to Vedas and Vedantic period. Now, subsequent to Vedic period, there have been many treatises written by our rishis, which have been instrumental, where the practices of Agnihotra are recommended. In particular, I will mention the Kashyapiya Krishi Sukti in chapter 1 and chapter 4 of Kashyapiya Krishi Sukti. It is specifically recommended that Deva Yajnas and Bhuta Yajnas should be performed for agriculture and environment. The second point is that both the methods are having, they are based on spiritual sciences. Actually, if you exclude the spiritual dimension from any activity, in fact, it is not possible to achieve the perfection in anything. I mean, that goes with every aspect of the thing. So here, the biodynamic farming, it is based on lunar cycles and certain astronomical positions of the constellations. And the core principle is that just as man, plant life is influenced by the stars, planets, heavenly bodies. Plants grow not only through the fertility of the soil, but with the support from cosmos, the rhythms of the sun, moon, planets, and wider constellations of the zodiac. Now here also, in case of Homa farming, it is based on Agnihotra, it is based on the planetary influences, it is based on the influence of cosmic energy. Agnihotra is the basic Homa for all Homa fire practices given in the ancient Vedic sciences. Now, heal the atmosphere, we have seen that heal the atmosphere and heal the atmosphere heals you is the basic philosophy. Yajna is tuned to the rhythm of nature, and Agnihotra is tuned to the biorhythm of circadian cycle of sunrise and sunset. Now, the third point that I am making, that similarity of the of these both the methods with the organic methods. In general, organic method means exclusion of chemical fertilizers and pesticides, use of organic method, biodiversity, cropping patterns to be preserved. All these are common to both the systems. So whatever is required to be followed as organic farming practices under the standards, say in case of India, we have to have NPOP standards to be followed for being organic. Incidentally, our farm was also certified under both the standards of NPOP as well as NOP standards. So this has also in common. Now, biodynamic distinguishes itself because it calls that it has a scientific, I mean spiritual base. It is a based on spiritual science. Now, Homa farming also, it talks about, it distinguishes itself from other organic farming because by providing the tools and techniques for reduction of atmospheric pollution and purification of elements like air, water, earth, through the performance of Agnihotra, Homa, and Yajna. So the uniqueness of Homa farming is that it provides tools, techniques, and the methodologies to deal with the pollution problems and to clean and purify the elements and the enliven and rejuvenate the energies that are there. Now, fourth point is that both are cow-centered systems. Cow-centered means cow is the basic component in the whole system. Now, in case of biodynamic farming, there are many preparations which are made, like BD500, BD501. These are the preparations which are made. One is called as cow horn manure, which they call it as a spiritual manure. And another is called as cow horn silica, which is used as a foliar spray. That is also prepared in the horn of a cow. Now, in case of Homa farming, in fact, here, cow is treated as a sacred. And all the products of cow are actually fully integrated with the Homa farming system. First is a gomaya, which is cow dung, gomutra, cow urine, which is used as a foliar spray also. Then panchagavya, a preparation of five products from this thing, panchagavya is also utilized. And havan products are also, extension of further extension is havan products. Havan products like cow dung cakes, cow ghee, then incense sticks and Homa biosil. These are the products which are used in the havan product. That means, for cleansing the atmosphere, when you are dealing with biosphere, when you are dealing with atmosphere, what you are using is actually the havans, yajnas, agnihotras, and for which also cow provides the basic ingredients. Now I come to the cosmic influence of the plant life. Now, biodynamic regards that the plant has what four roots, four parts. One is root, the leaves, flowers, and fruits. Now, all these four parts, according to biodynamic principles, are influenced by four segments of the zodiac. Now, these zodiac segments are given. That means there is an earth element, there is a water element, there is an air element, there is a fire element, and each one of these elements are governed by three planets basically. In case of Homa organic farming, there is a reference to Vruksha Ayurveda by Parashara, in which it is stated that circulating system, that is vascular circulating system, consists of Sindhani and Sira systems. Of these, Sindhani performs the function of transporting elementary fluid, which is called as Pancha Mahabhautika Ras, from the earth, from the soil, and with the help of the roots. Thus, the plant receives the nourishment and growth. Now, here, in case of Homa farming, as compared to biodynamic farming consists of considering only four elements, whereas Homa farming, we consider Pancha Mahabhutas, we consider Akash. And the most important thing about Homa farming is that it recognizes the forces of Akash, the fifth element. The subtle energies of both light and sound are actually to be attracted with the help of Shabda Tanmatra, that is mantras. The fifth element, subtle energies of both light and sound, to enhance the cosmic influence of planets on plants and animal life. According to Sankhya philosophy, the main element from which Akash is the main element from which all other elements are born, and it has its tanmatra as a shabda, or which is called as a nada or a sound, and its most omnipotent force is the subtlest force is a sound, light and sound, and which has got capacity to reach all the cosmos of the entire 27 constellations. Seventh part is this is a further development of cosmic culture in case of biodynamic farming. It was T. Gallen Hieronymus is the one who developed this. It's an advancement of cosmic culture, the biodynamic farming. It was basically related to the channeling of cosmic energy into the ground for the benefit of plants, and that is done. This is called as a cosmic pipe technology. Basically, cosmic culture is called as cosmic pipe technology, in which the principle, as per the principles